If you want to learn how to make a graph in Excel, you're in the right place. Today we'll learn how to make three of the most commonly used options and when to use them. If you're just getting started, one of these three will usually do. If you're looking for more advanced charts, you can check out our other charts resources, but the basic steps to make almost any graph will essentially be the same. Step one is to enter your data into Excel. As far as this step is concerned, let's say this is the data we'll be using. The most important task at this stage is to check the validity and accuracy of your data. Sometimes your data is extracted from other places or needs to be summarized into categories so that items which are the same are presented as one data point. You should also have data headings, since they'll be used to generate the labels on your chart. Step two is to decide what story you want to tell. This means you'll need to ask questions like, is my story about changes over time? Is it about proportions of a whole or a comparison of two or more variables? Doing this will directly affect the type of chart you will use. If you're not sure, you can jump right to step three, because step three is to highlight your data and insert your desired chart. So let's do that here. Here's our data. Remember to highlight only what you want to be included on this particular chart, because Excel will try to put everything that you've highlighted on your chart. If the data that you want to highlight is non-contiguous, select only what you need by holding down the Control key in between selections, like this. Once you've highlighted the data that you want to see on your chart, go to the Insert tab on your ribbon and choose a chart from the Charts command group. Excel can take some of the guesswork out of choosing the right graph with the Recommended Charts option. Let's click that command, and you can preview what your data will look like by clicking on each recommended option. It's a good starting point if you're not sure what type of chart options will work best with your data. There is a shortcut for the Recommended Charts option. Let's cancel. Once your data is highlighted, if you press Alt and F1, then Excel will automatically create a chart and place it on your worksheet. Pretty easy, right? So as you can see, a chart can be created in three steps, but it's possible that you'd like to customize your graph by changing, adding, or removing things like data labels, a chart title, axis titles, and a legend. This can all be done by selecting the graph and clicking on this green plus symbol in the top right corner for the Chart Elements shortcut. All the elements available for your chart will be shown, and they each have an expanding arrow to the right, offering more options. So let's click on Axis Titles. And if we click the arrow to the right, we can specify whether we want to see a horizontal or a vertical. Let's say we want to see both. So now the placeholder shows up and we can start typing. And notice that the axis title is being typed in the formula bar. When we hit enter, it becomes the axis title for the horizontal axis. Let's do the same here. And now we have axis titles. Let's do the same for our chart title. Let's call it Air Freshener Days of Freshness. And enter. And that now becomes our chart title. Once our chart is selected, we'll see that there are two tabs that show up, which are called contextual tabs, the design and format tabs. If we click outside of the chart, they go away. We can click on the chart and drag any of the eight handlebars to resize the entire chart. The four corner handles will expand the chart proportionately, while the middle, left, and right handles will make the image wider or narrower without changing the height. The middle top and bottom handles will make the image taller or shorter without changing the width. If you want to change the chart type, there's no need to start over. Just click on the chart, go to the Design tab, and click Change Chart Type. From here, you can select any of the available chart types. We use column and bar graphs to visually compare values across categories. The bars in bar charts are displayed horizontally, while in column charts, they're shown vertically. When we have data that shows trends or changes over a period of time, line graphs are usually a great choice. Here's an example. Let's delete this graph and say we wanted to measure how well the ever-fresh scent did for the four seasons. We can insert a chart, a line chart, and we can see how it performed for the four seasons of the year. So spring, summer, autumn, and winter. Visually, line charts are a good way to represent trends or changes over a period of time. Pie charts are another chart type that we'd like to talk about. While they're not technically considered graphs, pie charts are so popular that it does seem appropriate to talk about them here. So let's change to a pie chart. We click OK. Pie charts are used for showing how different elements contribute to a whole at a particular point in time. Let's add some chart elements so we can make sense of what we're seeing. We click on the chart elements icon, and we can add a legend so we know what these colors represent, and we can also add data labels so we can see the values represented. And we can see how well the scent performed for each of the four seasons. Remember we said that the type of story you want to tell will affect the type of chart you choose? Well, a pie chart is obviously a poor choice for this type of data. But what if you did a survey and you wanted to show customer preference for each scent? Then a pie chart effectively tells that story, as we can see here. There are times when the same data can be viewed differently, even though the same chart type is used. With this chart, we're seeing how well each scent did for different seasons. Each cluster represents a season, while the bars represent the number of days of freshness. But now let's switch the data that's on the x-axis, the horizontal axis, by going to the Design tab and clicking on Switch Row / Column. We're now seeing the same data, but now each cluster represents the scent, with the bars being each season that was measured, because the x-axis has now been switched to display the scent instead of the season. So we'd have to change the label that's on the x-axis. Cosmetic changes to an Excel graph can be made in multiple ways. The quickest way is usually to right-click on the element being changed and select a different font, color, text, or size, whatever's required. An alternative is to go to the Format tab once we click on the chart and make more advanced changes to a single element at a time. But if you want to change an entire theme or color scheme, you're better off going to Design and selecting from one of the themes that are here, or one of the color schemes under Change Colors. You can also format different elements just by clicking on the element. So if we wanted to make the axis label bold, we can click and make it bold. And we can change a single color. Let's say we wanted to change this series color just by going and selecting the color we want. So now you're ready to make charts of your own. Learn even more about Excel with GoSkills Basic and Advanced courses.
Ready to learn more about Microsoft Excel? Then check out the full course on GoSkills.com. Click the link in the description.